Good evening, everyone. Tonight, a Metro mom tells us she was terrified, but her reactions were quick when two men tried to rob her at gunpoint.
It happened at Johnson Drive in Greenwood in Shawnee around 8:30 last night, and that's where KMBC 9's Peggy Bright is now. Peggy?
Kelly, the woman had just picked up her kids from their grandparents' house. When she pulled up to this stop sign here, there was a car in front of her. But at the time, nothing seemed wrong. It all changed in an instant.
Before I knew it, the doors on the car in front of me flew open, and the next thing I know is they're next to me at my window with a gun.
The woman we'll call Sarah was stunned. Staring at her were two young men in ski masks, one aiming a gun at her.
The man was yelling at me, "Give me your money, give me your purse," and I just kept yelling at him, "I don't have any, I don't have any."
Then the men saw her phone light up. She had called 911. They scrambled back to their car as the operator answered. Sarah read off their license number. She says the only reason she was able to call is that she had her phone out for her son to call his dad. When she saw the men's masks, she dialed 911 instead. She has spent today thinking about the what-ifs.
That was really kind of scary, but at the same point, I was between the kids and the gun. And so that was my primary concern.
Her 9-year-old was in shock, her 8-year-old was screaming, and her 3-year-old oblivious. Sarah says she's learned a lesson from this she hopes will be valuable for everyone.
And I'll never, ever drive again without my phone right there in my lap where I can grab it. Very, very lucky.
Now, it turns out the same two men had been to another home right in this area where the homeowner had confronted them, also got their license plate. And then the two went over to Wyandotte County, but KCK police were right there when they tried to do the same thing to someone else, and the two were arrested. We're live in Shawnee. Kelly, back to you.
So, Peggy, how are Sarah's children doing tonight after such a traumatic ordeal?
Well, they did go to school today. The teachers were informed that they'd been through this traumatic experience, but they all seem to be doing better now that they know those men are locked up.
All right. Thank you, Peggy. Now, the suspects are 17 and 18 years old, facing charges in both Johnson and Wyandotte counties.